Welcome to Savita University LectureCast in Anatomy. We are going to discuss about the nerve supply of the face. The nerve supply of the face can be divided into sensory and motor. The sensory nerve supply is by the trigeminal nerve, which is the fifth cranial nerve, and the divisions of the trigeminal nerve are the ophthalmic division, maxillary and the mandibular division, and also the branches from the cervical plexus are the greater auricular nerve and the transverse cutaneous nerve of the neck. These are the three divisions of the trigeminal nerve, namely the ophthalmic, maxillary and mandibular, and the area of distribution we can see in this diagram. Coming to the ophthalmic division of the trigeminal nerve, the branches are the supratrochlear, which supplies the upper eyelid and forehead, supraorbital, which supplies upper eyelid and frontal as sinus, the lacrimal branch, which supplies lateral parts of the upper eyelid, infratrochlear, which supplies medial parts of both the eyelids, and external nasal, which supplies the lower part of dorsum and tip of the nose. Coming to the maxillary division, the branches are infraorbital nerve, supplying the lower eyelid, side of the nose and upper lip, and zygomaticofacial nerve, which supplies upper part of the cheek, and zygomaticotemporal nerve, which supplies anterior part of temporal region. The mandibular division of trigeminal nerve, the branches are auriculotemporal nerve, which supplies upper 2/3 of lateral side of the auricle and temporal region, buccal nerve, which supplies skin of lower part of the cheek, and mental nerve, which supplies skin over the chin. The branches from cervical plexus are the greater auricular nerve, which supplies skin over the angle of the jaw and parotid gland, and transverse cutaneous nerve of the neck, which supplies the lower margin of the lower jaw. Here we can see the area supplied by the greater auricular nerve and the transverse cutaneous nerve of the neck. The motor nerve supply of the face is by the five branches of facial nerve, which are the temporal branches, zygomatic, buccal, marginal mandibular and cervical branch. Coming to the applied aspect, the infranuclear lesion of the facial nerve, the phenomenon we term it as Bell's palsy, the whole of the face of the same side is affected, affected side of the face is motionless, asymmetrical face drawn up to the normal side, wrinkles disappear from the forehead, and attempt to smile draws the mouth to the normal side. Food accumulates in the vestibule. These symptoms occur because of the loss of the action of facial muscles. In supranuclear lesion, lower part of the opposite side of the face is affected. Upper part escapes due to bilateral representation in the cerebral cortex. Trigeminal neuralgia, which involves one or two divisions of the trigeminal nerve. Severe pain is seen throughout the distribution of the involved nerve, relieved either by injecting 90% of the alcohol in the affected nerve or by sectioning the affected nerve, which we term as a medullary tractotomy. Thank you.